Hello there. In today's session, we're going to be working with this question, which came from Rob Cass's book of 2008, Modern Actuarial Risk Theory Using R. So the point is, we will assume that X is a finite risk with maximal value of B. That means that the probability that X is lower or equal than V is just 1, but the probability that X is greater or equal than B minus epsilon is positive for all epsilon. Now, we need to prove that if pi sub alpha is the exponential premium for X, then this exponential premium tends to become the maximal loss premium as alpha goes to infinity. Now, what does this mean? Well, what this means is that this so-called exponential premium is just, take a look, 1 over alpha times the logarithm of the moment generating function of the random variable x evaluated at alpha. So what we need to prove is that this thing goes to just b as alpha tends to infinity. Now, to do this, what we need to do is first to write the definition of the moment generating function of x evaluated at alpha. That is just the expectation of this exponential here, which of course is just this integral, right? Times the density function of x evaluated at x times the differential with respect to x. Now, since in this case we're talking about a finite risk with maximal value of just b, then what we have is that we can just reduce this thing to the integral from 0 to b of the exponential like this times this density function like this. But now we can just write that this is just zero, the integral from 0 to b minus epsilon, right, of the same exponential times this density function plus this other integral. Now, this is true just for every epsilon. Just for every epsilon, because we're just using the additivity property of the integral. Now, please do realize about the fact that we can say that this integral is greater or equal than just this part here. Why? Well, because in here what we have is a positive function, and in order to little f to be a density function, it has to be a non-negative function. So what we have in here is that this is just like this, right? And since the exponential is also an increasing function, then what we have is that this integral here is just greater or equal than this product, right? So in here what we have is what? Well, this is just the probability that x is greater or equal than b minus epsilon. And again, this relation here holds for all epsilon a positive number, so we're gonna dub it star, right? And then what we'll do is just to write the exponential premium just like this, right? Logarithm of this moment generating function. But of course, this is supposed to be by means of these inequalities greater or equal than what? Then 1 over alpha times this natural logarithm of what? Well, we'll just use
this expression here, right? And write V minus epsilon times the probability that X is greater or equal than, I need to, okay, greater or equal. So 1 over alpha times the natural logarithm of all this here. V minus epsilon times the probability of X being greater or equal than V minus epsilon. So I close this brace here. And then what we have? Well, I can just distribute the logarithm among these two factors by using the one of its main properties. So what we have here is just the logarithm of an exponential. So that is just alpha times V minus epsilon plus 1 over alpha times the natural logarithm of the probability that X is greater or equal than V minus epsilon. So since by the definition here we saw that this number is strictly positive, then this natural logarithm is of course computable. So since alpha is supposed to go to infinity, then what we have is just that this expression here just goes to V minus epsilon plus zero as alpha goes to infinity. Now since star holds for every positive epsilon, then the same thing is true for this thing here, which means that what we have is that in the limit when alpha goes to infinity of pi sub alpha is just the maximal loss premium, and that is what we wanted to find.